My left breast has swollen so much, I couldn't button my shirt. And that's when fear set in. My name is Katrece Nolen, and I live here in Virginia. My husband, Keith, we have three kids, and they're two in college and one in middle school. It was right here in this room where we're at. I was playing on the floor with my son, chasing after him. At the time, he was just 3 years old. And crawling around, I just happened to look down and look in my shirt and thought, you know what? One of my breasts seemed to be slightly larger than the other. First thing in the morning, I'm going to call the doctor's office and schedule an appointment. Introduce myself, you know, brand new doctor. Hey, you know what? I think one of my breasts seems to be slightly larger than the other. So he did a regular breast exam, and he said he did not feel any lumps. The types of symptoms that you're exhibiting make us think that it's mastitis. But would you like to get a mammogram? Sure. Had the mammogram, and the radiologist said, you know, it looks like it's just some thickening in the skin. Fast forward, maybe a couple weeks later, and I couldn't button my shirt. So I remember the doctor saying to me, you might consider going to see a breast surgeon just because these are abnormal symptoms. And I brought the mammogram CD that they'd asked me to bring in and sat back down. They called me back up to the front and they said, Ms. Nolen, do you have the mammogram film? I said, well, I gave you the CD. And she said, well, the doctors require that you have the mammogram film. We're gonna have to reschedule your appointment. And while we're going back and forth, in walks a doctor in a white coat. She says, hi, Mrs. Nolen, I'm Dr. So-and-so. I went ahead and took a look at your information. And now that I see you in person, I suspect that you might have inflammatory breast cancer. The biopsy was a Friday. I got a call on a Monday confirming that it was cancer. And we met with the kids the very next day. We didn't know exactly what we were gonna say, but we knew we had to say something. Some of the challenges were just getting past the gatekeepers. How can I be heard? I felt like I wasn't heard. You see me, you suspect I might have this thing that I've never heard of before in my life. I looked up inflammatory breast cancer and just reading all the different symptoms, you know, life expectancy and all those types of things, I just burst into tears right there. Because it's inflammatory breast cancer, it needed to be chemotherapy first, then have a mastectomy, and then finish off with radiation. Essentially, they had to hit it hard. I knew from the very beginning, you will have to advocate for yourself. I was already of the mindset that I was gonna do that, that I needed to do it, and mostly it was because I didn't want there to be a chance that I wasn't here because I didn't fight hard enough. I found out, oh, you know what? There are expert doctors in inflammatory breast cancer. What? And so I called up and I said, hey, do you have a doctor that you could recommend? Because it turns out for inflammatory breast cancer, it is crucial that a doctor know what they're doing when it comes to surgery. 10 years later, I still see him every year. So lesson learned, speak up, ask for help, ask questions. If you don't know how to ask the question, then ask how to ask the question. I didn't see too many stories about Black women going through breast cancer and their families and how it was impacting them. And so that was one of the reasons I wrote the book. I not only share about navigating cancer and cancer resources, but also add a perspective about my husband, about my mom, about my sister and other family members, and what their feelings were when they heard about it, and how do they feel like they can actually impact the situation. I'm doing really well. I just crossed the 10-year mark. I feel like I've won the lottery, just given the odds that were against me. One, having the type of cancer, and then two, being a minority diagnosed with an aggressive form of cancer. This is your one chance. And if not for you, then who? You got to fight for yourself.